DJ, DJ Erica. Erica.
On What the F News, man. Unfortunately, we got two teen girls who decided to take their lives into their own hands and carjack, you guys, carjack a 66-year-old man who is simply trying to do his job and deliver Uber Eats food to people. Okay, these ladies, these young women, these children, actually, I can't even say the young women, they're children, 13 and 15 years old. These children, these juveniles, decided to jump into a car and attempt to carjack this man. And ladies and gentlemen, of course, I am not going to play the video, okay? I actually happened to see it jump down my timeline, okay, before it was actually reported out. And I hate that about the internet. I hate being able to just turn on an app or go on social media and see someone lose their life like this. But this video, I didn't know what I was watching because it just happened to be in someone else's post. And I'm like, what is this? And I click on it and you see the video of this man with himself halfway out of his car. There's a girl with a hoodie on and somebody, it looks like a person in the back seat, but you can't really see from the angle that the person was recording. Next thing you know, the car basically lose control. I don't know if the driver had hit the gas or whatever trying to get away, but whatever it was, the car lost control. He ended up hitting a guardrail, hitting like a stand post. The car continue to zoom down the street, hit around a corner, and flip over. And mind you, when the car hit the guardrail, this victim, unfortunately, his name was Muhammad Anwar. He was 66 years old. He was smashed, not once but twice. His body was smashed when he hit the guardrail, and then his body was smashed again and thrown from the car, okay? Suffering life-threatening injuries. They called the ambulance to try to take him to the hospital, and he died, ladies and gentlemen. And this is just so disgusting, and it's so sad. And unfortunately, they can't say who actually did it because these are minors. So there's not going to be a name or a face to the women who did that besides the video. And in the video, you don't really see her face because the young girl has a hoodie on. But I'm just trying to figure out exactly what in the world would lead a 13-year-old, a 15-year-old to do a carjacking. Why? What is going on? Like, did they not have parents? Who told them to do this? Because I don't see children just waking up in the morning and saying, hey, I think it's going to be fun to carjack. Now, according to them, that's what they're saying that they did. But I was also watching another show that was basically talking about how there's been a thing going on where they've been doing carjackings and involving children, because, you know, if a child gets arrested for a carjacking, they're going to get a slap on the wrist. But if it's an adult doing a carjacking, they're going to go to jail. So they'd be paying teenagers $3,000 to $5,000 to go and carjack people. And this is what I guess they were trying to do with this Uber Eats man, and it led to them killing this man in cold blood, okay, over a carjacking. Now I would like to see how this whole thing unfold, ladies and gentlemen, and if it's true that exactly what this person that I watched and listened to on the Breakfast Club, was it Envy? Yes, I think it was Envy that said that, from the Breakfast Club, allegedly stated that there's been carjackings going on where they involve the children, just so the losers, the adults who setting these kids up for failure, don't go to jail. And I wonder if that is the circumstance in regards to this case and in regards to everything that's happening up with this Uber Eats driver who was murdered. You know what I'm saying? It's so messed up, the society. It's so messed up. It's so messed up. And you know, all I can say is rest in peace, man. I just want to see how this is going to unfold, whether they're going to be charged as adults, will they be charged as minors, what will they be charged as. And it's just so unfortunate because, you know, they've thrown their entire life away. And will they be able to recover from this? Will they be able to live their life? Will they get 15 years? Like, what is going to happen? And do you guys comment below, do you guys think that these young ladies, these children, teenagers, who's been arrested and locked up for this man murder, do they deserve to be in jail for the rest of their lives? Or do you feel like they are victims of popping circumstance, or victims of being told to do something, or being peer pressured into doing something? Like, y'all tell me how y'all think this whole thing is going to unfold. There has been a GoFundMe put out from the family of the victim, basically asking for donations for his funeral. Y'all, it's crazy. And
DJ Erica.